Hi, I'm George Hirsch. Welcome to George Hirsch Lifestyle. Here's a great side dish that you might commonly see indoors, but we're going to take it outdoors today. This is an Idaho potato or russet potato that has been previously baked for 45 minutes at 400 degrees until it was just knife tender, where the knife just slipped right out. The potatoes were allowed to cool, and then once they're fully chilled, we're just going to take and make a nest with the potatoes. Remove off the top, cut out the pulp, but I'm not carving all the way through the potato. I'm only cutting through about 3/4 of the potato, as you can see. I didn't cut through the bottom, and I actually left the sides all together. So with the pulp that was removed from the potatoes, I'm just going to mash the pulp down. Then once you have it down in some small pieces, I'll take a tablespoon or two of sour cream and mix that in and begin to smooth it out. Almost like making mashed potatoes, same thing. Small amount of sea salt. Small amount of fresh ground black pepper, tablespoon of Parmesan cheese, a little fresh chopped parsley, just a tablespoon or two of Jack and cheddar cheese. Mix it all up. Now you don't want it really smooth and creamy. You want to have a little bit of a chunk. This way, when you're biting into the potato, you actually have a little bite. Next, go back to the potato. Lightly put it in. Try not to go over the sides. You want to stay inside the nest. Mound up the potato nicely. And then, of course, top it off with a little bit more cheese on top. Everything is fully cooked with the potato. The only thing you really are going to do is reheat the potato and also melt the cheese that's inside. If you're baking it in a regular oven, it's only about 10 to 15 minutes on a 375 degree oven, or better yet, bring it out to the grill on a medium to high heat for about 5 to 10 minutes. Better off, put it up on a higher shelf, and the smoky flavor that comes out of your grill will be a potato you can't beat. So here's a great tip you can take to your grill. I have here an acorn squash, which is sometimes not too recognizable even in the kitchen, never mind out by the grill, but I absolutely love this on the grill. It's actually my favorite way to prepare an acorn squash. All you have to basically do is take and split the squash directly down the center using a very firm knife, because it's a very hard squash. And then take the center and scoop out all the seeds. Very, very simply. And as far as anything you need to do in the kitchen, there's probably nothing is easier than preparing it and getting it ready for the grill, where it's really gonna be a treat. So I have my grill all loaded up with a whole assortment of kind of everyone's favorites. Of course, on the very, very top, it's a baked stuffed potato. And then on the main grill at a very, very high heat is a portobello mushroom, large cap mushrooms, which I'll use as the base for a very savory mushroom gravy. And then some nice multicolored baby peppers. When it comes to autumn or the fall or even the winter, is to use an acorn squash, because they go so good on the grill. And they are just so easy to prepare. You can just drizzle a small amount of butter inside them. And as far as finishing them off, maybe drizzle a small amount of honey inside the squash. And they just will continue to bake as if it's in its own dish. Now I'm gonna bring up a couple of these beautiful acorn squash. And the double stuffed baked potatoes.
So there you have it. My dish is made for just plain good eating. Good for you grilled acorn squash with honey glaze. Very satisfying double grilled and stuffed potato.
I'm George Hirsch. Remember, if I can do it, you can do it. See you next time.